the pitfalls you could get into if you're a guardian of an ancient crystal skull is to get too self-important. You know, we're just not that important. These skulls have had so many guardians, and we're just one. It's cool. It's sometimes frustrating, and we're privileged. And I think it's really important that we do the best that we can at the job, but it's just a temporary position. So I was kind of making fun being followed around by a big guy with a security shirt on. Actually, I travel alone most of the time with Synergy, and there's nothing more invisible or more safe than a middle-aged fat woman. It's quite easy to travel. Nobody notices me. Synergy comes from the South Pacific. It spent most of its existence in the South Pacific, most recently on a small island off the coast of New Zealand and Australia. I'm going to see if this really works. The particular tribe that had Synergy still has the twin of Synergy that they call Harmony. And the skull looks exactly like Synergy, but it's a mirror image. Stephen was talking about how the eyes of these old skulls are carved out of alignment. And if you look at Synergy, the eyes are crooked, the nose is crooked. And the oral history of these people is that the skulls were carved to represent actual bone skulls of their ancestors, and they claimed that the skulls came from Mu, or Lemuria. Like Stephen also said, they were not, there weren't 13 of them, but they were using groups of between 7 and most commonly 13. So this tribe's history says that they had 52 of them, and that they were used in different groupings in the South Pacific.